controversy in New York over scaffolding. Now, let me tell you, I love scaffolding. First of all, when you're in New York and you're in a suit and you're going to a meeting and it's raining, scaffolding provides the shelter. Scaffolding also represents clean windows. Somebody standing on top of that and making that window clean so you can see the beautiful city of New York. And the third thing is when I see scaffolding, I see jobs. Somebody's building something and someone is employed. Unfortunately, not everybody's happy about the scaffolding. I think there should be scaffolding on every block in New York. Diana, what do you got?
Bill, there's scaffolding in New York City almost old enough to vote. Just take a look at this building in Harlem at 100 Lenox Avenue.
How many years has it been up?
17.
Siobhan Nicholas works at the hair braiding salon underneath this scaffolding, a salon that's been struggling to retain clients because many people just don't know it's there. Also, as a result of scaffolding, you have a buildup of trash, and crowds also gather, and they smoke, they drink, and leads to more trash. So why is it still there? The Department of Buildings says the scaffolding can't come down until the owner of the building, in this case, the Panamon Housing Development Fund Corporation, does the repairs. The department can only fine the owners $1,000 a month.
I reached out to the owners of the building, and I haven't heard back.
There's scaffolding in New York City that is almost old enough to vote. And right across the street from my office, there's scaffolding that I don't know if it'll ever go down.
Councilman Ben Kalos is now putting forth legislation that would require the construction be done within 6 months and the scaffolding be taken down immediately. Critics say, mostly within the real estate industry, that it's hard to come up with the money to do these repairs within 6 months, to which Ben Kalos says, well, the city should then foot the bill and then get reimbursed later. But what do you say?
But in a very real sense, what is the city going to do about it beyond that? Because I don't think something like that passes. There is no way, with all the development in New York, you would grind construction projects to a halt if they thought they had to get it done within that 6 months. And then what about addressing the paperwork problem? How long it takes to get the right permits and work through the bureaucracy of the city?
Well, you're right. The legislation is struggling to get support right now. So all they can do is really just leave the scaffolding up and fine these building owners. But they're not paying the fines.
Bob, what do you think about this? Because I look at this and I say, wait a minute. You're blaming the scaffolding for homeless and trash? Why don't we blame the mayor who has let the city completely run away from where it was when Mayor Giuliani took it back?
Well, I think the mayor needs to do something about this for sure. The city is getting, we're in the city all the time, Bill, right? So we see the scaffolding, the stuff, the dirt, the trash that's building up. I understand all these concerns clearly.
But it's not the scaffolding's fault.
Well, the scaffolding certainly provides havens for this. You see this when you're trying to squeeze your way through and there's people there smoking and there's trash all over the place. The fact of the matter is, it is an eyesore and it is disgusting.
So I hear homeless problem, I hear crime, I hear littering, I hear non-compliance. This is all a failure of leadership at the administrative level in the mayor's office. It's certainly not the fault of the scaffolding.